got Simon Salt here with us. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me on.
And he's got the accent.
I know, you just love that accent.
I'm from Austin.
Austin.
Uh-huh.
And then prior to that, London.
Oh, okay.
Good day, mate. I ignore that. I always do that. It doesn't matter where you're from. I always say good day, mate. You could be from Africa. I'm still going to give you a good day, mate.
Thank you.
I've been waiting to talk to you.
I'm sure you have.
I mean, all weekend.
Did a survey, right, about the who, the when, the how of the mobile consumers.
Yeah. What all people are doing with mobile, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we live in a bubble, as we know. Digital.
What?
You know, we think we know everything about digital because we live in it. And
Why is he bursting my bubble?
It's okay.
I wanted to ask the questions of what the rest of the U.S. is actually doing.
You mean like regular, non-geeky
people?
Real people,
yeah.
Okay.
So when I was presenting yesterday, I asked the room, how many of you are still using feature phones? And one person put their hand up.
What's a feature phone?
Exactly. And yet, you know, the rest of the research tells us smartphones has just barely 50% penetration. So, you know, that room alone, 99% of the room were smartphone users.
Right.
So it just skews horribly when you do surveys amongst your own group.
Yeah.
You know, it's not realistic. And so I want to go out and actually ask the real question. You know, what do you do with your mobile phone? When do you use it? What are you going to pay for an app? What do you think about mobile advertising?
Yeah.
Is it a pain? Is it getting in the way? Do you actually ever buy anything? You know, because I know, you know, if I were basing it purely on anecdotal, mobile advertising was a complete waste of time because I've never bought anything from a mobile ad. And apparently I'm in the minority because...
Really?
Yeah, men, significantly more men will buy from a product from an ad on a mobile device.
Really?
Wow.
Yeah.
I would have never get... First
more
of all,
than women.
Like you,
I'm surprised.
Like you, I thought nobody was doing it.
And then
if you said, no, actually they are, guess who? I would have said, women?
Yeah.
And more so on
tablets and phones, I guess, because of the, you know, more real estate.
You
get them more involved. And
It's not because it's skewed, like more men have those devices than women, right?
No. That's all factored out.
Okay.
Yeah. So as a significant...
Okay, I have to skip right to a burning question.
Oh my gosh.
How many people were using their devices while they're on the toilet? Did you ask that question?
We did.
I have to know.
41% of men do.
41% of men.
And
so basically half
of women.
Basically half of us were sitting around texting and getting the job done.
Actually, regardless of these laws that are being brought in, 30% on average of both men and women are using their mobile device while they drive.
Oh, yeah.
Not whilst, because we also asked, do you use it when you're in the car not driving?
Right.
Which was higher. But no, actually, while they're driving, 30% of them actually admitted it to it.
I'm surprised it's only 30%.
Well, that's admitted.
That is true.
You know what?
I would never admit that.
You know what I want to do?
I'm perfect.
Oh, by the way,
and
I do it.
I'll admit it.
So he does it.
I'll tell you right now. This shows you how skewed it is. Because if they pulled us 100%,
right.
But 30%, okay, maybe I can buy it. Now. The fact that I do it myself doesn't mean I want anybody else to do it, okay?
I don't want those idiots to do it.
Eyes on the road.
I get mad at people when I see that they're swerving because they're on their mobile device. I'm like, come on, people.
Oh, they're in the outside lane at 45 miles an hour, guys.
Yeah, that pisses me off.
Hang up.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, here's what I'm going to do about it.
But we think that we can do it better.
Yeah, I can.
In reality, I'm not sure.
Because we're digital nomads and we multitask.
Exactly.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. I have a solution for it, though. I drive a big silver truck, like a giant Nissan Titan pickup, okay?
You can't do it just because you can run over everybody on the road.
Yeah, I can. But the point is, here's what I'm going to do. Have you seen those train horns that you can get installed in your car?
Yes.
I'm going to get one of those. I'm only going to use it when I'm driving and somebody's on their mobile device and they're swerving in my lane. I'm going to give them, the train horn and just make them just...
crash.
They will crash, but they will never text again while
that's
they're...
Very true.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think everyone should do that, but you're only allowed to use the train horn when people are texting.
Here's the thing. I won't actually work long term. They'll get scared. They'll put it down.
Yeah.
They'll for the rest of their trip.
That's
but the next
said,
time they get in the car...
That's why I said everybody needs to do it.
You know, but somebody somewhere, some bright spark in Washington is going to produce a bill that enforces or encourages most manufacturers to install some kind of device in your vehicle that stops.
I hope they do it.
That's already in progress.
I hope they do that. You know why? I'm going to start the first company that builds a product to defeat it.
The radar scanners.
Absolutely. Yeah. I'm going to manufacture that. I'm going to be so rich. Yeah. Because you know that's going to work about as well as prohibition did here in the 20s or whenever the heck that happened. Okay, that's not going to work.
People will put their phone outside the car.
That's right.
Yeah,
drive down the street like this.
Right.
They got Bluetooth. They can hold it out here and Bluetooth it, you know. Okay,
what else are
people doing? And you know what I want to know. What else are people doing? When are they using these phones and mobile devices?
I know what you want to know. And actually, it's the men that are despicable.
Really?
Yeah, it is.
I completely agree with that.
Well, that's a general,
I don't even know where you're going with that, but I agree.
As a general rule, that's true, but how are they specifically despicable?
We asked a couple of fun questions, and we put one of those data points into an infographic, and 11% of men claim to use a phone during sex, and 4% of women claim to use a phone during sex.
Wait, are they incorporating it into the act, or are they just...
We didn't ask that specific use. Yeah, exactly.
Okay,
They just were on the phone during sex.
Okay.
Now, I don't know. I mean, I'm not sure who the guys are calling.
Maybe
asking for advice, maybe.
Yeah, it's like maybe they need a little help.
A Dr. Phil hotline, and where do I go next?
Right, I don't really know what to do.
I've got lost here. I'm not sure.
Yeah,
but we also found that men were significantly more likely to use their phone at work, and men were significantly more likely to use their phone secretly. So if you want to real fun correlation causation mistake, you could say that men are secretly having sex on the phone at work.
Right, of course.
That's perfectly logical. I understand that, yeah.
Which is, I always love when people look at data and
go, they're like,
these three things are connected.
Right.
Well, because it's all
that makes perfect sense.
That puts a whole new take on sexting for me.
Right.
Exactly. I'll never talk to anyone on the phone at work again.
Well, being that we're on a tech show, I thought the one really interesting part out of the sexting piece was the operating systems.
Mm.
So of our respondents, of those who owned an Android phone, 14% said they sexted frequently, that is, once or more a week.
Okay.
19% for iOS and BlackBerry, tied. Now, this is not overall. This is of those people who own that device.
Right.
29% of Windows Mobile.
Wow.
Sexed frequently. Now, when I told them that in the presentation yesterday, somebody said it's because of the frustration. I think it's either that or Windows has finally found its mobile community.
That's right. And by the way,
they're not going to embrace it.
Guys, now you know that when you're out at the bar, you want to find your first question to a lady is, what kind of phone do you use?
Exactly.
And if she's on Windows... That's extra bonus points, right?
I think one of the other things that you looked at was age.
Yes.
When children should be getting their new phones.
Yeah, and there was actually a significant difference, but it's funny, there was a significant difference in the response rate,
sure.
But the age rate is very close. So for men, it was age 12. And for women, it was age 13.
Wait, the women saying that their kids should get
a phone at 13.
So 12 and 13?
Yeah, so about that 12, 13 age was actually, you know, unified for both of them. What was interesting out of that is, okay, so you've got these teens who are getting smartphones, and then we looked at how do you manage them?
Yeah.
And the millennials, about 23% of millennials monitor what's on their children's phones.
Mm.
Gen X is 30%, so they're all over their phones. And baby boomers was only 11%.
Well, because they don't know,
They don't know how to do it.
Yeah, and that's actually a pretty fair assessment. It's like, well, so mobile is actually causing that gap within the family.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, because the kids understand mobile and what you can do on it, and the baby boomers don't.
Yeah.
They don't understand that their kids can access the internet on a smartphone and see whatever they want. So great, they're monitoring their computers,
right?
But the kids are just circumventing that by using a tablet.
Computer, why would I want to be tied to one location?
Yeah.
I've got this, I can go anywhere.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
So it was interesting.
Very
split.
Interesting, yeah.
We're going to get the wrap up here in a minute, I know it. And so, I want to know where I can go get all this. I want to see this report with my own two greedy little eyes.
He wants to make his own connections.
Oh, yeah, I have to
make
some connections
here.
So
we're going to be producing the full report and putting it on theinkslingers.com. And we're also going to be producing a series of infographics that people can download.
Okay.
That we'll pull out some of the juicier data points that make sense to people, and they can use those. So.
And will you let us know, like, via Twitter or something when it's ready?
Yes, absolutely.
Very
in fact,
nice
people,
segue.
The people who came to my session yesterday got to sign up. I did a 24-hour sign up so that they could get the first view. But yeah, we'll absolutely be promoting the heck out of it.
And what is your Twitter?
At Inkslinger.
And do we get?
Yes.
So you're going to give us a little insider hookup
here?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Okay. And next time you should also include me in the survey because you'll get some weird answers. I'm sure that I'm...
Right. Don't ever include him in a survey. Screw it up.
Thanks for joining us today,
Simon.
Sal.
Thank
That's fun
on.
Stuff.
I love your name, by the way. Simon Salt.
Yeah, that is a good name.
I didn't invent it. It's a real name.
Better
yeah, good.
Than John P.
Yeah.
All righty.
All right,
well, Mark
will get
can get that contraption off your head
Thank
there for you.
You
and